Hi and welcome to this How Do I video, where I will explain how to embed Power BI reports in Microsoft Dynamics NAV. In this video you will see the required steps to configure the Power BI service and Power BI accounts, as well as Power BI reports to add them to a user's role center. We'll go there following these steps. First, you need to authorize the application to be able to connect and fetch reports. Then I will demonstrate how we can select reports, make them available to a user. Then we will see how we can navigate and work with the reports in the Power BI part in the application. And I will also demonstrate in the last step how you can share reports amongst your colleagues within your organization. But first, let's get started with the first step, in which we will see how we can authorize the application so it can select reports from the Power BI service. I start the application, and as you notice in my application, I am logged in as a user Peter Shadow. This is his first time within the application, and Peter would like to see some reports. So in his role center, he scrolls down until he notices the Power BI reports part, in which he can select the Get Started link. Once we do that, you see a pop-up window appearing, in which I can authorize Azure services to make a connection. I only need to do this once. I select my user, I confirm the password. When I enter it, the authorization will be made. As you notice, but the NAV17 application needs permission to access Power BI reports. You need to accept these permissions and then you can continue to work within the application. Now we have reports which we can select. At this moment there are no reports available, but I will explain how to get them in the next step. After we have authorized Power BI, then from the Power BI reports section on the Role Center, we can select the drop-down menu next to the Power BI reports header to access or select our reports. Let's see how that works. So Peter goes into the application where he notices there are no enabled reports at this moment. We use the Select Report button to select our report. Here we can see all of the available reports at our disposal. And the idea is that we click here on the Enabled button. Now the way to do this is to go to the menu, open the Home menu, make this list editable. Once the list is editable, and only when you can edit the list, I can click on the Enabled button. Then I select OK, and next the Power BI report part will update and display the report which I have just selected. As you notice, the report is now available within the application. In step 3, I will demonstrate how we can use the available options in the Power BI report part in the drop-down menu to expand and navigate over our reports. So Peter goes to the application to the Power BI report part, where he notices the available reports. At the bottom of the report part, he can navigate, go to the next report and the next report and so on. And using the button with the three dots, he also gets an overview of the available reports, which he can then select and then have a look at. Now, as you notice here, the reports contain a lot of information which are not clearly displayed in the report part. So to be able to get a good look at the report, Peter opens the report part drop-down menu and selects the Expand Report option. This opens the report in a bigger window where Peter can see the report and can make use, for example, of the filters which are provided in the report. The report displays as it would display on powerbi.com with all of the interactive features available in the report. So for example, from within the NAV application here, I look at my Power BI report. It's completely interactive. I can use the expand option to go over the report and have a look at all of the information which we have available in this dashboard. I can then close down the part again, go to the drop-down menu, and also from within here I can navigate to the next report, to the previous report, and so on. So the Power BI report part is completely managed via this drop-down menu. If any other reports become available, I will also be able to select them here in the Power BI Reports selection. In the next step, I will demonstrate how we can make more reports available. In the next step, I will explain how to share reports, because to be able to see a report, you need access to it. And to do that, we need Power BI security, not Dynamics 365 security. And I will demonstrate how you can share reports in your organization on powerbi.com. Peter's manager, Steven, is logged on to the Power BI service website and would like to share a report with Peter. In this case, this S3 dashboard. So what happens is that Peter's manager navigates to the dashboard and then makes use of this share option on the dashboard to share it with Peter, or goes to the right top of the page and there selects the share option. Here I can, for example, grant access to Peter from my organization. I can also select other users via their name and or email. If I go to the Access tab, I can also determine which actions are allowed. For example, for this report view, I can stop sharing or disable the possibility to reshare. So from within this pane, once I select the share option, the report, the dashboard will be shared with those users. It's successful, and the user will now receive an email in their inbox. So Peter goes to his email, where he notices a new email has arrived that explains that Steven has shared a report, in this case a dashboard S3. From within the email, Peter can click on it and will then be redirected to powerbi.com. But that's not what Peter wants to do. Peter would like to access this report within NAV. So within NAV, Peter navigates to the Power BI Reports tab, where he then uses the Select Reports option. As you notice, the dashboard has now also become available. Peter selects this dashboard, which will now also update the Power BI Reports part, in which he can now also see and use that dashboard, which contains a much nicer report. Next, Peter can then also expand that report and have a look at all of the individual details and parts of that report, which has been shared by him and by his administrator. As you can see, we have the full functionality of that report available. Let's summarize the steps. In step one, I demonstrated how you need to authorize the application to be able to show the reports. Then we had a look at how we can select reports in the pane, make them available to a user. Once they are available, we had a look at how we can navigate over reports. And last but not least, we also had a look how we can share reports on the Power BI service. This video covered the following topics: view Power BI reports within Dynamics NAV and personalized reports. Please have a look at the following resources to get more information. Thanks for following this short video to explain how to embed Power BI reports in the application. This video in the How Do I series for Dynamics NAV is brought to you by Microsoft and Platan. See you in the next one.